Well, as counties across our area contemplate banning those so-called bath salts, law enforcement agencies are having to get more familiar with the chemical turned drug.
News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local from our Spartanburg newsroom. And Mike, what did you find out?
Well, Nigel and Gabrielle, we talked to one deputy who really knows a lot about this issue, and he says he believes the bath salts are becoming more common, partly because the price of meth is going up and meth is harder to find. Both substances produce similar highs.
It's kind of out of control.
Lieutenant Ashley Harris is a chemist at the Spartanburg County Sheriff's Office. The amount of cases coming to his lab are up 36% since 2006, and he's expecting the numbers to keep rising, thanks in part to the bath salts craze.
It's just going to really bog us down a little bit.
Right now, it's not something he deals with a lot because the so-called bath salts aren't illegal yet.
What you're dealing with is chemicals that are really bad, but they're ahead of the curve of the government.
It's important to talk to a chemist about this because these bath salts aren't what their name implies.
They're also sold under the name plant food.
They kind of resemble what they're called, but bottom line, they're chemicals that keep changing, which makes them very dangerous and harder to control.
And you could go and buy it one time. Let's say you used it and it made you feel good, it gave you a high. The next time you go and buy it, they're going to put whatever they can find in this mixture. You may get a totally different mixture and it could have adverse effects.
Lieutenant Harris says he's seen methamphetamine become more popular recently, and he says bath salts are gaining steam too, partly because they're basically viewed as training wheels for meth.
Bath salts are almost a substitution for methamphetamine. They're cheaper than methamphetamine are by the gram. And a lot of people think they're safer because if they're not controlled, obviously they've got to be safer. You're buying them from a company, you're not buying them from a dealer on the street.
He also tells us that while meth has become more popular, crack and cocaine have become less popular around here. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg newsroom.